wanted to shake hands with somebody. Don't just come here without meeting somebody. I say, God bless you. You're welcome to the Redeemer's Campus Fellowship, the inauguration of this wonderful thing that God is doing, the inauguration of this good place to be in. And as you do so, please be seated and sit majestically in the presence of the Lord. Amen. God bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. God bless you. My name is Remy Oshikonlu. I pastor the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Chapel of Greatness in Hempstead. And by the grace of God, I'm the Assistant Zonal Coordinator for Zone NY8. For some of you, you may not know the Redeemed Christian Church of God is a Bible-believing Pentecostal church with over 800 parishes in North America. I thought somebody would put their hands together for Jesus. And our zonal coordinator is Pastor Olukayode Babalola. Unfortunately, yes, let's put our hands together for Jesus. Pastor Babalola is not able to be here today, but we have our zonal mommy, Pastor Mrs. Ann Babalola, who is representing him ably. And we have pastors from our zone, Pastor Shoda Made, the church is in Farmingdale, Pastor and Pastor Mizoloide, the church is in Baldwin, and Pastor Fajolu and Pastor Mrs. Fajolu in the back, the church is in Freeport. And so wherever you are in the world, you could find a Redeemed in over 190 countries. I think the last count was 195, but let's even say 190 countries. As I sat here, Pastor Babalola just said, Pastor, you are giving the word. So pray for me that God will give me grace. Amen? But the work of God is based on obedience. So I'm going to spend, I don't like talking too long. Maybe 10, 15 minutes and the work will be done. I just want to tell you what we're doing. This campus, I'm really so proud of you guys. You know, God will bless you. God will honor you. What you have started, or what God is starting with you, 100 years from now, if Christ tarries, a good word will be said concerning you. Amen? Yeah. Because the zonal coordinator had a vision to start the Festival of Life. It's been a little challenging, let me put it that way. And we had one here. And he said the fruit of that Festival of Life program will be to have a Christian fellowship in this school, and we want to be doing it in all the schools. And we did a research and we found out that we did not have a registered Christian fellowship here. They have a Muslim fellowship, they have a Hindu fellowship. We have other fellowships, but we didn't have a Christian fellowship. So what you're witnessing today, you may think of it as no big deal, but it is a big deal. And we give God all the glory. So again, I want to thank God for the life of the visionaire, and I want to thank God that the vision has started. What I'm going to share with you, as I was told, you know, just share a word, is you can look at the book of Luke, chapter 2, verse 41, I think, to 49. If you look at Luke 2, Joseph and Mary always traveled for the Passover, and they traveled to Jerusalem for the Passover. And after they finished everything, they were going back home. On their way back home, they couldn't find Jesus. But they said, oh, it's no big deal. Maybe Jesus had gone with his other relatives. And then they couldn't really find him after 3 days. And they came back. Can you imagine? After traveling, they came back to look for him. And after searching for him everywhere, they went to the synagogue and they found him there. If you look at that chapter in the Bible, Luke chapter 2 from verse 41 to 49, they were saying, where are you? Why? We've been looking for you everywhere. But before that, they said Jesus was listening and discussing with the people that were in the synagogue. He was listening and discussing with them. And the Bible now said, Jesus answered his parents and said, why were you looking for me? Don't you know I'm about my Father's business? Why is this relevant for the message today? If you do a little research, you will find out that Jesus was only 12 years old. And he had determined in his heart that he was about his Father's business. And so when you see young men and young women here, most of you, I'm sure you are in your 20s, maybe somebody is in 19 here or just about, but I'm sure all of you are over 18. And so Jesus started going after his Father's business at the age of 12. So nobody here is too young to begin his Father's business. I'm so excited and so proud of you that you are about your Father's business. And you will continue in your Father's business in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. Through you, millions will come to the realization that there's only one way to the Father, and it's through Jesus. Amen. While others decide to waste their lives drinking, smoking, taking drugs, going after women of easy virtue, men of easy virtue, you have chosen on a night like this to spend your time glorifying the name. I pray for you that the light of God will so shine through you. Amen. That men will give glory to God.
Amen.
Let's go into the secular world. I've been studying Dr. King, not because it was his 50-year assassination, but I like to study biographies. And it gives you insight, because if somebody lived for 70 years and you read about him, you just get 70 years experience in 3 hours or 10 hours or 48 hours of reading. So why don't you just, why are you trying to reinvent the wheel? Go read. I discovered that this young man, Dr. King, graduated about 16 or 17. Out of college, you won't believe it. He was actually a genius. It wasn't that he just stumbled into faith. But apart from that, the core of his work started at 26. And by 39, Dr. King was dead. And so nobody here is too young. Don't start feeling that you are too young. Let the older people do it. The Bible said in Joel 2, 28, it says that the young men will prophesy. And it says the older people will be dreaming dreams. And Daddy Joe likes to joke that you have to sleep to dream dreams. So older people are always a little dozing off. This is your time. You are like a bullet in the barrel. Pull the trigger.
That's right.
This is your time to arise, shine. And for the glory of God, you are not too young. Anybody that is going to be doing anything tangible has to start. You know, we used to say, early to bed, early to rise, make yourself healthy, wealthy, and wise. Don't worry, you don't know that kind of stuff. But what I'm saying to you is that this is your time. You're not too young. The general overseer of this mission, he's 76 years old now. I tell everybody I can tell. As we pastors are going around, I'm almost 50, and people are over 50, everybody's doing their thing. The general overseer that God used to take this church to over 190 countries became general overseer at 39. How much older are you, or younger are you? JFK, that you go to the airport, oh, JFK, JFK. He became president, I think, at 43. And he did not start his career as president. He had already gone into the army or Marines. He had done his thing. He came back. He was a senator. He was doing things. He had already started his life. Even President Obama was president by 47. And he did not start as president. So what I'm saying to you is that this is your time.
Amen.
And what God is using you to start today is the right way to start your life. You are at the right time, in the right place, in the right season, to be blessed and to be a blessing. God is no respecter of persons. He doesn't look at age. Jesus started at 12. Joseph got his vision at 17. If you read the story of Joseph in the Bible, by the age of 30, he became prime minister. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they were called Hebrew boys. They were not men, they were teenagers. And they became governors and prefects over society. David, King David, was a young boy when he was anointed king. The anointing does not respect age. The anointing respects availability. If you make yourself available, God will use you for the work at hand.
Yes.
Don't ever think you are too young. Remember that it is better you start young. You find your purpose, you ask God for revelation, you spend time in the house of God, and you run with it. And I pray for all of you that as you have begun this journey, you will not be weary,
Amen.
You will not fall,
Amen.
You will not fail, and none of you will miss heaven.
Amen.
Through you, Suny Old Westbury will be taken for Christ.
Amen.
And through you, New York will be taken for Christ.
Amen.
Through you, the United States of America, North America, and the world will be taken for Christ.
Amen.
Finally, the general overseer of this mission, he came from a small village. He teases us that the village was not on the map. The general overseer of this mission, by the grace of God, Pastor Iye Adeboye, God has used him to take over the world. So when I pray for you that you will take over, you are not in a village. You are in the greatest nation on the face of the earth. You are in a great institution. If God can speak to a young man from a village in Africa, and today that church is in over 190 countries, what God has started as Suny Old Westbury will be the beginning of great and mighty things.
Amen.
I'm blessed to be part of you. You can let me come in once in a while as a guest, and we will encourage you. If you need anything by the grace of God, God will help us, the zone, to provide for you. But what you need is to hear from God. And God will do, just make yourself available, and God will do the rest in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's put our hands together for Jesus. Father, we thank you. We just bless your name. We give you glory for the word that has come forth. And we pray that your children will run with it in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. So tonight, we are here for just one purpose. That's the main thing. To inaugurate this campus fellowship. And as I said, for those that are just joining us, our zonal coordinator is not here, but he's here technically, because God said what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. So they usually say the better half, but I will say the half, because both of them are better. Amen. So the blessed half of the zonal coordinator of New York 8, I'm going to invite Pastor Anne Babalola to give a few words, and then she will invite the fellowship officers, and she will pray for them, inaugurate the fellowship, and all the fellowship members, she will pray for them also. Let's put our hands together for Pastor Anne Babalola. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Who is excited to be here tonight? I am excited. Clap for Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Pastor Babalola would have loved to be here tonight, but I know he's excited already about what's happening here tonight. We thank God that this is actually coming to reality. This is marvelous, marvelous in our eyes. I want to thank Pastor Remy and his team, who worked tirelessly to make sure that what you see today is happening. This is God's doing. God has recorded this in heaven. Amen? And at this time, I'm going to be inaugurating this fellowship, but there's a youth pastor who will be praying for first, and then I will invite the officers. I'm told there are 5 officers, and we'll pray for them, pray for everyone else who is involved with this new thing. Before I pray, I want to read a few scriptures. And this is essential for the new pastor to know his duties. Amen? So if you give someone an office, you say you are now the CEO of this, you give them all their duties, the responsibilities of what they're supposed to do. So you want to call this his duties and responsibilities, which I hope he will remember even as he pastors this church. So please, if you have your smartphones or any device at all, open with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 9. And I'm going to be reading from verse 18 through 27. So it goes, what, this is Apostle Paul asking a question. He goes, what is my reward then? Verily that when I preach the gospel, I may make the gospel of Christ without charge, that I abuse not my power in the gospel. For though I be free from all men, yet have I made myself servant unto all. So the youth pastor of this ministry will not abuse his or her power. The youth pastor of this ministry will be servant unto all. So everyone here who comes to this ministry, who comes to this fellowship, will be served by the youth pastor, that I may gain the more. So the more he serves or she serves, the more they would gain more people for Jesus. And unto the Jews I became as a Jew, that I might gain the Jews. So people who look different from him, or from the leaders here, people who you would call a cast out, or people who you would, an outcast, or people who you would look onto and say, they can't fit in because they put on, you know, they have a lot of tattoos, they look a certain way. Those are the people God has called you to come into the church and the ministry. It says, and to them that are under the law, as under the law, that I might gain them that are under the law. Anyone who may be oppressed or suppressed, that whether you know about them, those people are the ones God has called you to come out of oppression, to come out of suppression into the house of God. These are the people that God has called the youth pastor of this church to really, really call to God, to be drawn closer to God. To them that are without law, as without law, be not without law to God, but under the law to Christ, that I may gain them that are without law. People who don't know God, people who are lawless, people who really don't like to hear the word of God, people who are drug dealers, drug users, abusers, people who are out there who feel like they really have to do a certain thing to get recognition. But people who steal, who cheat, who lie, who backbite, those are the ones that God has called this youth pastor to. He hasn't come for the good people. He has come for the lost. So the pastor of this church, his duty is, or if it's a female, her duty is to ensure that all those people come to the marvelous light of God. Let me hear you shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And then, to the weak became I as weak, that I might gain the weak. I made all these things to all men, that I by all means save some. The job of the youth pastor is to save some. Not all will come here. Not all would listen. Not all will want to do everything and anything. Sometimes you may be frustrated, but don't be frustrated, because God hasn't called you to all, that you might gain some. Your job is to gain some. If you gain some, you've gained what God has asked you to gain. Amen? And this I do for the gospel's sake, that I might be partaker thereof with you. You are running a race, and in this race, as the youth pastor, you must maintain a temperate spirit. The youth pastor must be temperate in all things. When you're dealing with students, you have to be temperate. Sometimes you'll be frustrated. Sometimes we'll do things that will frustrate you. But God expects you here in 1 Corinthians 9, I believe this is 25, that you would be temperate. I pray in the name of Jesus that even as we inaugurate this church, the youth pastor, who is now brother, when he rises up, he becomes a pastor, Brother Olufemi Oloyede, that God Almighty will use you in Jesus' name. Let me invite him to come forward, Brother Olufemi Oloyede. Please come forward. He's going to be the youth pastor of the church. Clap for him as he comes. And Brother Femi, can you kneel down, please? Amen. I'm going to read Acts 13, verse 2. What we're doing now is an Acts 13, 2 thing. Amen. What you see here is not strange. He's being separated. There's a separation happening right now. He's being separated from a job, a duty. He's consider him to be CEO, whatever you want to call him. He now has a duty, and we're separating him for this duty. And I'm going to read. As they ministered to the Lord and fasted, the Holy Ghost said, "Separate me, Barnabas and Saul, for the work whereunto I have called them." Before the foundations of the world, Olufemi Oloyede was called for this work. Before the foundations of the world, before he was even formed in his mother's womb, God called him and set him apart for this work. What we're doing is we're doing what has been done and completed in the spiritual realm, in the physical realm. That's all we're doing. It's been concluded in the spiritual realm. All we're doing is we're sealing it in the physical. And verse 3 says, "I have called them, and when they had fasted and prayed and laid their hands on them, they sent them away." They were sent forth. This is, we're sending him here. He's come from his parents. He's come from a home. He's come from another local church. But he's now going to be the youth pastor of this fellowship. I'm going to lay hands on him. And all I require of you, if you can speak in tongues, to speak in tongues. Right now, connecting with the Holy Spirit. But if you're not able to speak in tongues, speak. You can pray in understanding and follow me. Amen. And the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Olufemi Oleede, I commission you in the name of God the Father, the name of God the Son, and the name of God the Holy Spirit, as the youth pastor of the Redeemer's Christian Fellowship, Suny Old Westbury, Long Island, New York, in the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, and the name of God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will overshadow you. The Lord will help you. They will lift you up. Assistance will come your way. Whatever you say to go will go. Whatever you say to come will come. This work will not be hard for you. The Lord will send you helpers. From the east, he will send you helpers. From the west, he will send you helpers. From the north, he will send you helpers. From the south, he will send you helpers. You will not weep. You will not mourn. We will not mourn over you. You will not regret taking this assignment. In the name of Jesus, Jehovah will lift you up. From today, because you have agreed to do this assignment, the heavens above you remain permanently open. In the mighty name of Jesus, I say with your hands, you will run signs and miracles. In the mighty name of Jesus, before you speak, heaven will answer. While you yet speak, things will happen for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, and your family will not regret anything over you. You will not weep over your family, and they will not weep over you. All the days of your life, it will be well with you. Everyone that God has assigned to you, they will cooperate with you. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I want to call on the officers. If you know that you're an officer of this Christian fellowship, I want you to come out at this time. I know there's Sister Omo, there's Sister Osato, and I think there's a brother, Tino. Please clap for them as you come. All the officers that are here, where's Sister Omo? Where is Tino? If you're here, come. I want the pastors of the Redeemed Christian Church of God to please surround me. And participate also. Where you are, I want you to begin to pray for us. This is a serious job we're doing. It's a serious assignment. Believe me. But we need you, your help. There's a foundation that's been laid today. It's a foundation that I know for a fact will stand the test of time. Pastor Remy said 100 years from now, they will talk about these people in the mighty name of Jesus. And I believe so. Let's begin to pray. Pastors, begin to pray. Raise the lamentation. Raise the lamentation. Raise the lamentation for the three of them, that all of them begin to pray. That the Lord Almighty will guide them, will be with them. No evil shall befall this once, because they have chosen to stand for the Lord. Jehovah will stand with them in the name of Jesus. Provision they will need, whatever they need, the resources they will need, let there be provision in the mighty name of Jesus. The sun will not fight them by day, but not soon by night. But God will preserve their soul, He will preserve their destiny from this day forth, even forevermore. No evil shall befall them, they will not fall. Father, we adore you. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your loving kindness, oh God. We are glad to call you Father. This is your doing, my Father, and it is marvelous in our sight. Take all the praise and glory, Daddy, in the name of Jesus. In agreement, oh God, we declare, we decree that your glory, your Shekinah glory, will rest upon this one in the name of Jesus. I will pray for you. You will not fail. You will not fall. You will not falter in the name of Jesus. The grace of God, the anointing of the Holy Ghost, will rest upon you afresh in the name of Jesus. The spirit of wisdom, knowledge, understanding, in the fear of the Lord, rest upon you today in the name of Jesus. The Lord I have born will help you. The Lord I have Peter will help you. The Lord I have Abraham and Moses will help you in the name of Jesus. When you call on one, thousands will answer you. Thousands will answer you. And to declare to go, it will go. When you command to come, it will come. They will listen to you. I said, men will listen to you. The word of God will not be cast in your time. Receive grace for revelation, for new unction, for new grace, for new anointing. In the name of the Lord Jesus, every conspiracy of God against your life and against your destiny, we stand upon the rock of ages, be paralyzed, be destroyed, be scattered. In the name of Jesus. The Lord says, I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. No gates of hell shall
shall be able to prevail against this work in your life in the name of Jesus. You are sent for, and it is well with you. The Lord is with you. The Holy Ghost is with you. The grace of God is with you also. In the name of Jesus, you will succeed. Where others are failing, you will excel. Where others say there is a casting down, you will see that there is lifting. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be my Father. In Jesus' name we have decreed. Amen. Amen, amen. Let us please just come and shake their hands. Stand up. Pastor Olufemi Oloyede, the Lord bless you. Congratulations. Congratulations. Amen. Just come and, you know, shake hands with them. And
let's put our hands together for Pastor and Babalola. God will bless you. God will be with you. As God has used you tonight, the Almighty God will continue to be with you. And for all the pastors in NY8, I pray that the Almighty God that has started this new good work will continue to abide with each and every one of us. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. This is just the beginning. Many more campus fellowships. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
I just have one quick assignment before we turn it over to the campus fellowship. If you are here and you know you are a member of the Redeemers, or you have decided to be a member of the Redeemers Campus Fellowship, and please stand up wherever you are and wave your hand so I will know where you are. Anybody that's here, apart from the officers, that, and then, okay, please come forward, so that we'll know who the members are. Please come forward. Please come forward, including the officers. Anybody, and if there's anybody outside that is on assignment, but you know you are a member of the Redeemer Fellowship. What about our musicians? They are not members? Yes, come out. If you are a member of the Redeemer's Fellowship, and you know that you are starting with them, today is the inauguration day. Let's just see who you are. God bless you. God bless you. Who is taking photographs? Or you are just broadcasting live? Because it's nice to have the first set of members. Could you just line up this? We let your pastor be in the middle and let people fan out. And then whoever has an iPhone, you can come close and take a good photograph. Come together. We'll be able to have this in prosperity and say, these are the guys and the ladies that's captured. Are you able to capture? That's two. You got two way out. You have to. So maybe there are two lines or something. Smaller people in the back. So maybe, yeah, sure. I want us to be able to catch everybody. Come on that side. Can you imagine 100 years from now, they'll be looking at this photograph and say, oh my God, how did they dress in those days? Amen? All right, take photographs. God bless you. Hallelujah. Has everybody taken photographs? Please send me some. My phone is dead. Okay, praise the Lord. I want all of you to form a circle. Just hold hands. Just hold hands, because You are starting something that is awesome. Hold hands, the circle spread out. One big circle. And I want everyone to rise up. And let's just stretch our hands towards them. And just prophesy into this wonderful. Take photographs as well. I think this is such an important moment. This is such a great moment that as God has brought them together to start this good thing, that these names will not be mentioned in prison.
Amen.
These names will not fail.
Amen.
These people that are here, this is just your beginning. I command you to arise, shine.
Yes.
As you are arising, you are shining.
Amen.
I command in the name that is above every other name that it shall be well with you.
Amen.
We will never sorrow over you.
Amen.
Your parents will have cause to rejoice concerning you.
Amen.
The world will celebrate you.
Amen.
Because you have put your hands on the plow, you will never look back.
Amen.
This ministry that you have started, the Almighty God will strengthen you to fulfill the purpose in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And as you leave this college, doors of favor will be open to you.
Amen.
Doors of victory will be open to you.
Amen.
Doors of good success will be open to you.
Amen.
Your academic pursuits will be stressless.
Amen.
You will excel in your studies.
Amen.
You will graduate on time with honors.
Amen.
Jobs will be waiting for you. When others say there's a casting down, you will say there's a lifting up.
Amen.
You'll be a source of pride to your parents.
Amen.
You'll be a source of pride to your church.
Amen.
And through you, millions will come to Christ.
Amen.
The Almighty God will fight all your battles.
Amen.
And you will hold your peace.
Amen.
All the days of your life celebration will be your portion.
Amen.
When it's time to get married, God will connect you to the bone of your bone and the flesh of your flesh. When it's time for you to have children, it will be effortless.
Amen.
As you have started this good work, favor, mercy, and goodness will follow you.
Amen.
All the days of your life,
amen.
And it shall be well with you.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
And the people of God said, amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes, I want to appreciate everyone. Thank you for coming. It's a real privilege. And we take this for granted. Thank you so much. But before we go, I would like to share with you the vision and the purpose of this fellowship. As you under the name of this fellowship is the Redeemer's Campus Fellowship, and our motto is get involved. We want every one of us to get involved in the things of God. We are here to show you and for you to experience Christ, for you to experience what He has been doing in our lives. Are you here to testify of His goodness so that you too can experience the same thing that we're experiencing? I'm telling you, people of God, Jesus is good. And He's the best friend you can ever have. Friends will fail you, but Jesus will never fail you. So I want you to know that we are here for you on campus. We are here to cater for you spiritually, emotionally. Even sometimes when you are disturbed with many things, come to us. I know God is ready for you. As you come, may God Almighty attend and cater to your needs in Jesus' name. So lastly, without much ado, and the purpose is to reach out to individuals on campus through Bible studies, worship service, and community outreaches. And furthermore, we endeavor to create fellowship university, as we have said, we already have that we individuals will be encouraged, will be equipped and empowered to become fully functioning followers of Christ.
Yeah.
You know, when we have Bible studies, we usually say we don't want to just come and go back. We want that to show in your life and your character.
Yes.
We want to practice what we teach you. As we all know that it is not by accident that we're here today. God brought you for a year for a purpose. And you never go back home the same way, in Jesus' name. I'm going to call Sister Esosa. I always call her Esosa, but her name is Osato. So I apologize many times. She said, don't worry, it's okay. Don't worry, I understand. So I'm going to invite her for testimonies. 5 minutes quickly, just have the testimony of what God is doing. Give your hands together for Jesus as you come through.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Our God is faithful. Good evening, everyone. First, I just want to thank each and every one of you for coming out to support Redeemer's Campus Fellowship. We gladly appreciate it. Thank you guys so, so much. My name is Osato Hamwendo-Bazi, and I'm the Vice President of RCA. When we first started this fellowship, God gave Femi a vision, which was to reach out to individuals on this campus through Bible studies, worship services, and community outreaches. He told me about this vision, and I quickly accepted it. In doing this, we started a Bible study group. At first, it was overwhelming due to the fact that nobody was showing up. Suddenly, the Holy Spirit made a verse in my heart, which says, Galatians 6:9, which says, "Let us not be weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest." Many of us, when we start a ministry, we are so quick to end it because nobody's showing up, the crowd is too small. But we have to see that God is not looking at crowds. God is looking at our heart. We stop the ministry, we say, "Oh, nobody's coming up," so we quickly stop it. God is not looking at that. God does not care about size. God is looking at our heart. So when we started this Bible study group, many people were not coming, but gradually God did it. People began to come, and then people's lives were transformed. We have covered topics on forgiveness, love, peace, and so many people have given their lives. Which is the best decision anybody could ever choose. Because Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And I just want to encourage each and every one of you attending Suny Old Westbury to come to our Bible studies. Because, trust me, it's really, really good. So I want to encourage each and every one of you to come to our Bible study group. It's taking place at Hall 2 in Woodlands Hall 2, and it's on every Sunday from 7 to 8. Thank you.
So it's from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. It's more interactive. You ask questions, you contribute, and we answer the questions that we have answers to, and what we can. We pray the Holy Spirit who answer that for us. Amen.
Amen.
So the next thing now is we're going to invite quickly, because of our time, we're running behind schedule. I'm going to invite for David. He has some rendition for us. And after that, we're going to see Timmy and Mutumayo. Get ready for your rap. It's going to rap for us. And then also, get ready. Mrs. Pastor Victoria. She's going to give us a song. As you listen, you bless in Jesus' name.
Praise God. What's going on, everybody? In the church denomination that I grew up, not that I grew up, another one that I'm in now, it's an evangelical church, but they do this celebration that's on the Christian calendar. They call it Eastertide. And it's nothing, you know, too fancy or weird, don't worry about it. It's just another way of saying that what Jesus did for us never ends. We're going to continually celebrate Jesus every day of our life. Me personally, but I'm just going to, before we go into the song, I'm just going to say a little bit of a testimony of mine. I feel it on my heart to share something. Keep playing, brother. I'm part of InterVarsity Christian Fellowship. I don't know if Omo mentioned that. There was a small student-led fellowship ministry that we had on campus. And I realized that there's such an importance of what Redeemer, what you guys are doing. Because we had done such a good job of letting people know about Jesus and at least having them come to Jesus, but little to no follow-up because there was no church or ministry to root them and disciple them. So I think it's wonderful that you're coming here. Like I was saying, oh, there's two fellowships now, but now that's God, and I think that there can be a communication and a teamwork to happen to bring people to Christ on this campus because they need it. Our sister in the front here said that to lead people out of oppression, and that really stuck with me because I'm seeing as I go on campus every day, next semester is my last year, but I see such a burden for the students on campus because I know that not only spiritually, but in tangibly and physically, we're also being oppressed in a lot of ways. You can have poverty of spirit, you cannot know God, you cannot be reconciled to God, not know Jesus, and at the same time, you can be impoverished, literally. You can, you know, not have points in your account to eat food on campus. I used to be a resident here, so we want to help solve those problems, not only just spiritually and emotionally, but we want to actually help you in your real life. Some of us without fathers, mothers, so many things going on campus, as I meet these people. And we're gonna work together. We're gonna bring them to Jesus and also save them in each and every way and free them in each and every way. Praise God. Lastly, just personally, Inter Varsity Fellowship that I was a part of, we believe in students and faculty as well, transformed. Campuses renewed, we need better cafeterias, we need better things in the name of Jesus. We're gonna actually have those out on Old Westbury campus. We love them, they're doing their job, but we need that new facilities. And world changes develop because our students are gonna come out of here and change the world. Students like me, we're not just gonna, you know, actually stay within our Christian huddle. We're going to have some time for ourselves, but we're going to face the world.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
We're going to be a Christian covenant community, not a Christian clique. Amen. Keeps us to itself. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. And so that's enough of me talking. Praise God. Love. This song is called, thank you. It's called Just For Me by Donnie McKirkin. Jesus did it just for us.
Oh,
was a wonderful one. I was lost in the spirit. Amen. I was lost in the spirit forever. It was a wonderful one. So I'm going to invite Pastor. I'm so sorry.
Thank you.
Worry not. Good evening, everyone. My name is Tony Alomo. And I'm here to share the love of Jesus with us. So we're going to sing this song together. I don't want to talk too much. I've been touched really by what I've heard this evening and re-challenged. Because we tend to close in on ourselves and form a clique rather than reach out. Everything is about the love of Jesus. We're just privileged to know him. He introduced himself to us. So, this song is titled Incredible Love, and we'll share it together. So this is your part in the song. La, 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 la. That's all. La, 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 la. La, 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 la. Go and help me. La, la, join up. La, la. Can you say that? La, 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 la. La, la. Don't worry, don't play. La, la. La, 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 la. La, la, la. I'll tell you where to come in. Your love for me is incredible. Your grace for me indescribable. Your care for me incomparable. Oh, how well you carry me. You pick me up from a world of sin and make me to be like you. That's the point. Your love for me is indescribable. Oh, how well you carry me. So we go now, la la. 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 His love for you is incredible. His grace towards you indescribable. His care for you incomparable. And you too. Oh, how well he carries you. He picked me up from a world of sin. And you too. Just to make you to be like him. And the grace is available. His love for you is indescribable. Oh, how well he carries you. Let's go. La, 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 la. La, la.
La, 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 for me is incredible. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Hallelujah. That was a wonderful one. Thank you so much. Really appreciate that. We're about to come to the end of tonight's event. And just want to call on Sister Osato Worship. Okay. All right. We're just going to rise to our feet.
Praise the Lord. We're going to invite Pastor Oluyede Senior. Who is the dad? Who is the son? Okay, they are now brothers in Christ. Amen. Look at that. Can you really say who the dad is? For his son to continue the work of God. Hallelujah. So Daddy, with God, will give us the closing prayer.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. Immortal God, invisible God, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
The author of everything, we give you all the glory.
Amen.
We thank you for the grace. We thank you for the mercy. And we thank you for the peace of God in our lives. Father, accept our time in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We thank you for a day like this. Daddy, let your name be glorified.
Amen.
Daddy, I have prayed that this we have done today shall be permanent in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And ever we stand unto it in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So shall be one.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And as many that are present here that have not even given a hand to Christ, that Lord God will touch your heart in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
When the trumpet will sound, none of us will find wanting.
Amen.
We shall together make heaven.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That Lord God will give them the function from above to function.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
None of us here will not fail God.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
For in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Fellowship, one, two, go. With the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Surely, His goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.